It'll cost the budget $8.6 billion, but the government has delivered on its promise to put cash back in the pockets of Australians in last night's budget, with Treasurer Josh Frydenberg delivering plenty of relief for costs of living as part of the $8.6 billion spend. Petrol prices will drop by 22 cents after a cut to the fuel excise tax, which came into effect from 12:01 this morning.
The Morrison government announces a new temporary, targeted and responsible cost of living package to ease these pressures.
Because what we're doing for cost of living pressures in this budget is because of the cost of living pressures. The war in the Ukraine has pushed up fuel prices and Australians are feeling that. And it's not just at the Bowser, it affects the price of food, the price of groceries, and they need that support now.
In a further attempt to win over votes, there were $250 cash payments for pensioners, carers, job seekers, veterans and concession card holders, while there was also a $420 tax offset low and middle income earners. Now attention will turn to just when the election will be called, with an announcement expected within days. But it's not going to be an easy run into the election, with even one of the government's own members taking aim. In an extraordinary speech on budget night, outgoing Liberal Senator Concetta Fierravanti-Wells launched a scathing attack on Scott Morrison and Immigration Minister Alex Hawke.
In my public life, I have met ruthless people. Morrison tops the list, followed closely by Hawke. Morrison is not fit to be Prime Minister, and Hawke certainly is not fit to be a minister.
It follows her departure from politics and being demoted to an unwinnable position on the party's Senate ticket for the election.